Greetings everybody there, and you are watching Dot Play, and today we are counting down our favorite top 10 moments of Iron Man. I'll do a part 2 taking all the moments from his latest movies, so don't lose your patience if you don't see your favorite moments like the suiting up of Mark 50. So just wait for part 2. Best moments of favorite hero, that is of course Iron Man. So let's start with our marvelous moments. So, starting off our list, number 10 is rescuing the villagers from the Ten Rings from Iron Man 2008. Newly painted Mark III armor. Check. Badass ready to fight attitude. Check. What else is left? Some bad guys that deserve a lesson to be taught. When Tony watches the news and sees the Ten Rings killing innocent people in Gulmira, he suits up with his newest Mark III armor. There's no better way to give it a real world test. In Gulmira, a father is torn away from his family, instantly prepped to be executed. His son cries and pleads to the Ten Rings to spare his father's life. The violent terrorists pull the child away and proceed to brutally beat the father. As the father about to be shot, Iron Man launches down from the sky and lands in his signature heroic one-knee pose. Taking out the offenders with repulsor beams and tiny smart missiles, Iron Man saves the village. However, one cowardly Ten Rings member tried to escape and hide. It's not long before Iron Man finds him and tears him out from behind a wall. Throwing him to the villagers, Iron Man tells the once bullied victims, "He's all yours." 9 is guiding the nuclear missile to the Chitauri from the Avengers 2012. It's an iconic moment from the Avengers. Tony Stark may be arrogant and a little self-centered at times, but he really steps up to the challenge when it counts. As in the case when the people above Nick Fury sent a nuclear missile to destroy all of Manhattan in the hopes that this would also win the battle against the Chitauri. As the missile is fired from a fighter jet, Iron Man chases it down and grabs hold of it. Ignoring the advice of both Steve Rogers and Jarvis, Tony is adamant that this is only the way to save Manhattan. He saves his final words for Pepper. However, as she is distracted by the news, she doesn't hear Tony phoning in to tell her goodbye. Using all the powers from his repulsors, Iron Man guides the missile right through the Chitauri portal and sends it to their base. When it detonates, the Chitauri fall. However, Tony has made the ultimate sacrifice. With his Iron Man armor losing power, he falls unconscious and back through the portal. Number 8 is firing a rocket and walking away from Iron Man 2008. Right after saving villagers in Gulmira, Iron Man launches off to head back home. However, the Ten Rings aren't going to let someone disrupt their plans that easy. A tank shoots Iron Man out of the sky and he plummets back down. Landing with a violent hurt, getting out of the rumble, Iron Man annoyed shakes it off and fires a very modest wrist-mounted rocket at the offending tank. And like all cool guys, he just turns and walks away, knowing what the result will be behind him. The tank is destroyed in a glorious explosion. Iron Man then proceeds to destroy the rest of the Ten Rings' heavy artillery. Number 7 is Iron Man vs. Thor in the forest from the Avengers 2012. What happens when you have two headstrong people wanting the same thing? You get an epic battle that levels a forest. After taking Loki into custody, S.H.I.E.L.D.'s Quinjet is invaded by Thor, who wants his brother back on Asgard to stand trial for his crimes. Tony, believing that Loki should be under his custody, goes after Thor. An airborne Iron Man tackles Thor and crash lands him into a forest. The two trade a few quips at first, with Iron Man doing most of the insulting. The verbal feud quickly escalates to a battle of Mjolnir, powered lightning and repulsor blasts. At one point, Thor unknowingly charges Iron Man, which allows the Golden Avenger to blast Thor with a full dose of his own medicine. When Captain America steps in to stop the fight, Thor attempts to strike him. However, Cap raises his shield in defense. As the two legendary weapons collide, a powerful shockwave knocks the three Avengers over and levels the forest. That, my friend, is how you end a superpowered fight. Number 6 is linking arms to save all of Air Force One from Iron Man 3 2013. Being a genius inventor, Tony Stark is also a master at improvisation. Now, Here is Tony's ingenuity and creativity better demonstrated than his rescue of all 13 passengers on Air Force One when the aircraft starts to go down. As an extremist enhanced soldier blows a hole through Air Force One, passengers are sucked out into the open, free falling to the ground. Iron Man first consults Jarvis, who tells him that he can only carry 4. Not good enough, Tony needs to save 13 passengers. Defying all odds, because they're what Tony is good at, Iron Man reaches for the first passenger and tells her that they'll be playing Barrel of Monkeys, where he'll electrifying her arm so she doesn't let go. One by one, Iron Man saves all the passengers by linking their arms together. Reaching a safe altitude, Iron Man gently glides them into the water where they will be retrieved. Crediting everyone with a good team effort, Iron Man is unexpectedly hit by an oncoming truck which separates the armor into dozens of pieces. However, we quickly discover that Tony has been remotely controlling his armor this whole time. Yep, Tony Stark is a genius. So going towards the top 5 is suiting up with Mark V at Monaco from Iron Man 2 2010. Tony Stark takes the meaning of mobility to a whole new level with his Mark V armor. At the Monaco Grand Prix, Ivan Vanko aka Whiplash makes his violent introduction by slicing the front hood of Tony's speeding Formula 1 car, flipping it upside down. Happy Hogan and Pepper Potts see Tony's in need and speed to the raceway to save him. Arriving at the nick of time, Happy pins Vanko against the wall with his car. As Pepper yells at Tony to get in, Vanko continues his assault. Happy finally opts to hit Vanko multiple times in order to subdue him. Happy's efforts are futile, which prompts Tony to request his suitcase. But Pepper's attempts to pass Tony his suitcase are hampered by Happy's desperate maneuvers at trying to keep Vanko's at bay. When Vanko slices the side of the car off with his energized whip, Pepper sees a chance and tosses the suitcase right in front of Tony, who plunges his fist into the receiving receptacles. The Mark V armor quickly wraps and forms around its owner, transforming him into Iron Man. Number 4 is Midair joining with the Mark 7 armor from The Avengers 2012. Tony warns Loki that he needs to fear the Avengers, which are composed of the best of the best. As Tony continues his speech, he slightly puts on a pair of silver bracelets. Tony continues to explain to Loki that there is no endgame to what he is playing. The egomaniacal Loki then approaches Tony and attempts to control him by touching his scepter to Tony's chest. Unknown to Loki, Tony is protected by his arc reactor. A frustrated, unamused Loki throws Tony across the room. Tony calls out to Jarvis, preparing his trusty AI to execute his plan. As Loki lifts Tony up by his neck, Tony commands Jarvis to deploy. Loki violently throws Tony through the window, where he free falls towards the ground. Suddenly, a red and gold casket-like object shoots out and accelerates towards Tony. As its sensors lock onto Tony's silver bracelets, the Mark 7 armor wraps and assembles itself to him. Iron Man fires his repulsors second from hitting the ground. Boosting back to Loki, Iron Man hits him with a powerful repulsor blast and dedicates it to Phil Coulson. Now going towards our top 3, number 3 is Iron Man vs Hulk, debut of the Hulkbuster from Avengers Age of Ultron 2015. Under Scarlet Witch's control, Bruce Banner becomes an enraged Hulk and goes on a rampage in an African city. Iron Man quickly calls his orbital tracking platform Vernonica for assistance, prompting the Hulkbuster armor to be launched. Why, with the Hulkbuster armor modular pieces fully assembled around Iron Man, he implores Hulk to listen to reason. This only angers the Green Giant even more. The Hulk stampedes toward him and an epic battle ensues. At one point, the Hulkbuster has its arm torn off, but Vernonica quickly replaces it with a spear. Seeing the devastation from their battle, Iron Man attempts to fly the Hulk out of a populated area. However, the Hulk rage fueled strength veers them off course and into a building. Iron Man saves an elevator full of people and then uses the empty lift to hit the Hulk. Using all his might for a single punch, Iron Man actually knocks out one of the Hulk's teeth. the Hulk infuriated more than ever pummels Iron Man. Who is escaping the Ten Rings, Birth of a Hero, from Iron Man 2008. Kidnapped and held hostage by the Ten Rings, Tony Stark's life is saved by Jensen, who removes shrapnel embedded around his head. The first thing Tony builds is an arc reactor to replace the makeshift electromagnet inserted into his chest by Jensen. As days passes, Tony and Jensen work together to construct something that looks nothing like a missile, the Mark I armor. Both Tony and Jensen, well into their escape plan, start the power-up sequence for the Mark I, but it's taking a bit too long. Jensen runs off and attacks their captors to buy Tony more time. When the sequence finally finishes, Tony unleashes the Mark I onto the Ten Rings. The unstoppable Tony pauses his advance when he runs into Jensen, who's dying from being shot. Still hopeful that Jensen will live to see his family, Tony urges him to move. Jensen finally comes clean, revealing that his family is already dead, and he's going to go see them now. With a mixture of both sadness and gratitude washing over his face, Tony thanks Jensen for saving him. Jensen's last word to Tony are to not waste the second chance at life. So, our number one is Summoning the Iron Legion from Iron Man 3, 2013. Tony Stark isn't just a popular guy among people. He seems to be a popular guy among machines too. Well, he built them, so they better be loyal. In the final battle with Aldrich Killen and his extreme enhanced soldiers, Tony calls forth his Iron Legion. Dozens of armored suits coded to him and ready for battle. With the enemy outnumbering them, Rhodey makes the comment that he would kill for some armor. Tony, with one more trick up his sleeve, looks towards the distance where the familiar glow of a repulsor beam rapidly flies towards them. Soon, Tony and Rhodes are greeted by the Iron Legion, awaiting orders for their next move. Tony tells Jarvis to target the heat signatures of all the extreme targets. The armored suits go to work, each battling the enemy in its own specialized way. So this was it, guys. Thanks for watching. I hope you liked my video. I hope you liked all moments of Iron Man. So if you want more of Iron Man, subscribe the channel and wait for part 2. So what were your favorite moments from this list? Comment below. And if you liked all moments, then give a thumbs up and share. So until next time, I'll see you later.